August the 15th, the well was empty. We no longer need this or this, our trusty red string, or a tape measure. We have a new way of measuring the depth of the well. After watching our videos, my friend Stuart decided that we should automate our well measuring. And this will bring us into the 21st century. And he put together this little box here. He needed the final piece of the system to make it work, which was a pressure transducer. Stuart had a chat with his friend John, who is an expert on wells. He works all over the world on different well pumping systems, and he happened to have a transducer on his shelf. Just before Christmas, James and Maggie brought the batteries for our new device. And inside the box, there is a USB stick which collects all the data.
Hey, look, well level. How cool is that?
This device is a pressure transducer. It's going to measure the depth of water in our well. Well, I certainly don't need to measure the depth of the water here. I can see it's absolutely full. This well holds about 70,000 litres of water. We have two wells on our property. This one that I'm standing on top of is the big well. It's 10 metres deep. When this one was looking like it was going to run dry, we cleaned out the other well to help us get water from there, which I'll show you now. We're just above our small well now. We have a little 12 volt pump with a battery and a solar panel to pump the water up out of the well into this tank. It's a bit green right now. We've got some little steps to get down into it. And maybe we'll use it to cool off in when it's hot again in the summertime. If I went in there now for a dip, I'd come out like the Incredible Hulk. The green swamp monster coming out of the well. That should hold the cable. Not so sure that's going to work.
So it would also work on this, actually, as a jigsaw.
Well, what's happening?
Well, the wellometer is in the well.
Is it?
And we're just making some little brackets to mount it.
Excellent. Right.
We just don't have quite the right tool for cutting the...
Do we not have wire snippers that we bought?
Yeah, they won't do it.
Scissors. The big scissors.
Yeah, maybe.
The famous steel cutting scissors.
Yeah.
Eyeball this. And that will be close enough.
Oh yeah, the wires are mighty short actually, aren't they?
Yeah, well there's plenty of...
There's plenty of that, but yeah, this one.
But yeah, this one's quite short.
Well, the screw is just about long enough that it'll reach.
It'll reach from there. Yeah. Well, even without much sun today, it's charging. A few more little cable ties, tidy up the cable. Screw this on properly. I'm guessing these yellow bits actually come off the corners and they're just shipping protection.
I think
so. No, maybe not. Let me show you what this device is all about and how it works. Inside this waterproof box, there's a little device which takes a signal from the transducer that's on the end of this wire here, down in the bottom of the well. The pressure transducer converts the pressure it is seeing, into an electrical signal. It's a 4 to 20 milliamp signal, which comes up this wire into the box. Device inside here, which converts the 4 to 20 milliamp signal into a display, and it logs it on a little USB stick. The little devices in here, the screen and the USB logger, need power to operate. So we have a solar panel, a battery controller, charge controller, and then inside here are two batteries. So the wellometer measures the depth, displays the depth on the screen here, and inside the box there is a USB stick which collects all the data. It logs the data every hour, so we're going to be able to see how the well empties and refills. We'll be able to see the change when we take out a known volume of water. So if we put 1,000 litres into this tank, we'll be able to see how that changes on the depth data. What's going to be really interesting here is if we can see how the well refills with rainfall. What we really need to make the data really meaningful and useful is a weather station, so that we can log the rainfall and compare that to how the well refills, and also how the well empties. How long after it's rained or stopped raining is it before the well starts dropping in level? Or will the well hold all the water until we take it out and put it in our IBC or on the garden? How quickly does this well replenish? We don't really know. We will only find that out with experience and logging the data.
I like the baler twine touch.
Ah, that's temporary until we've got the right size screws to screw it on.
Wellometer says 9 metres. Well, guys, are you happy?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes. We have a little solar panel here, which provides a bit of charging. We go through a little charge controller, make sure we don't overcharge the batteries. And that goes in through a gland into our box. And every couple of months, we can come along, take the USB stick out, and download the data logging and see what the well has been doing over time.
Well.
The wellometer. Many thanks to Stuart and John for putting this fantastic device together for me, for us, not just for me. And I hope to see John and Stuart come and visit us in the near future. We'll see you next time.